So in this video, I'd like to talk about installing a tower clock in Stamford, Connecticut. GE Appliances is building a co-create space. It's going to be a brand experience center, and you can see here what it's going to look like. This is a virtual walkthrough. But along with showing off all their brands and what they do, in the back is going to be actually a factory. It's going to be a factory that makes product. It's currently already in operation up there, right near the train station in Stamford, Connecticut. And one of the things we wanted to do is honor kind of the history of the company. And that factory is modeled after Bridgeport, Connecticut, which was an old GE appliance factory. And the clock up there we saw was a critical part to really, you know, honor the history. And what we did is we looked to the clock that was actually the original on the GE headquarters in New York City, built in 1932. And the building soup you can see going up there was nice enough to allow me to get up, get close to this. And this is what we modeled everything after. You can see this is on Lexington Avenue. It's a beautiful Art Deco building and just a gorgeous design. Cast, you can see the hands are probably cast aluminum, but everything we did was modeled after this. And this is where we're going to put it. This is on the facade of the factory. You can see the aluminum plate we made in the back. This face is not cast, it's made out of Ren shape, and it was CNC'd. If you look at the early videos, you can see some of that work. It's got little keyholes to lock this in. You can see Austin up there having a little bit of difficulty finding those because it's blind, of course. But you'll see, we'll eventually get this thing set up there, we'll get it in place. But the way this works, there's a motion works that's in the back that gets a signal from the clock. The clock's going to be remote. It's going to be in an area that's actually a museum honoring the history of manufacturing up there, where we'll display the actual clock. But the first thing was getting this face mounted up there. We have wiring that was already pre-installed in the wall before doing this. You see, Austin got it done. And looking good up there, it's about 3.5 feet in diameter, a little bigger than the original clock. Here you can see Ron putting the electricity, the wiring for the motion works, and the hands are put on place. This is the clock that's remote. Videos were about it. You can see where the signal gets sent from, that little micro switch there. But I think a real fun project. Nice, a lot of people involved helping out. Came out, looks great up there. Be glad when this all opens up. Hope you enjoy.